Hello everybody, welcome back to my channel where skincare is all about progression over perfection, because perfection does exist. Collecting skincare and owning more skincare than anyone could ever possibly use is one of my favorite things to do. It's a hobby of mine, it's a career, but it's not the right thing to do. No one needs to own this much skincare, right? And even though, yes, I'm an influencer and I get gifted stuff, because it's a hobby of mine, I still spend money on skincare. However, there are some items, some products that I just, to cut costs back a little bit, I've decided to no longer buy. And just these little areas where in the whole, I've saved quite a fair bit of money. Speaking of saving money, here's a quick word from today's sponsor. Before we get into the rest of the video, today's video is sponsored by Karma, formerly ShopTagger. Karma is an app and Chrome extension that ensures you never miss a price drop or a coupon code. They've had a bit of a makeover, you know, they're growing, they're expanding, and the name Karma represents the good karma that you get while shopping with them. I love using Karma on websites like YesStyle, where I kind of want to buy more skincare items, but I know I don't really need it, or I shouldn't buy it, or maybe it's a little bit pricier than I'm used to. And Karma allows me to organize these products whilst also getting discount on them. Karma's super easy to use. You just click on the link that you'll find in the description box and add the Chrome extension. You then head over to your favorite websites, shop as normal. You can add items to your wish list. This is my skincare wish list. This is where all the products from multiple websites get saved. This makes it kind of easy to almost plan your shopping by organizing items into multiple wish lists if you want. So sometimes instead of checking out right there and then, I wait for them to go on sale, and Karma lets you know. They can send you push notifications and emails to let you know when your products are on sale, they have a special offer, or they're back in stock. Even if you want to check out there and then, Karma actually scans the internet for relevant coupon codes, saving you even more money. However, this does only work on the Chrome extension on your desktop. You can also earn cash back now via PayPal when you shop from select retail partners. As I mentioned, you can download the Chrome extension through the link in the top of the description box. But yes, it's going to save you time, it's going to save you money. Download the Chrome extension. You'll want to turn on the push notifications and save yourself some money. I feel like we all need to save some money nowadays. But thank you again to Karma for sponsoring today's video. Okay, we're back. Remember, all the things I'm going to talk about, if you love using these and you love them, they're still good. They're just not for me, you know? So carry on using whatever works for you. We've talked about sheet masks so many times and how I don't really use them anymore and how they're a bit wasteful, but I'm going to bring up sheet masks again, and not for the wasteful reason, we know they are, but within that, I'm also going to add lip masks, I'm going to add under eye patches, basically anything that tells you to keep on for 5 minutes or more, I just stopped buying, and here's why. When it comes to sheet masks, first of all, what they usually promise is the effects of whatever serum the sheet mask is doused in, and it's doused in serum. Brands often will go on about how they've got one whole bottle of serum in one sheet mask, which, why would you ever need, like, you're not gonna, why would you ever use a whole bottle of serum on your face in one go? What sheet masks are great at doing is hydrating your skin, adding hydration to your skin, forming that occlusive layer, letting everything really work and settle into your skin. But what I wouldn't say they were great for example, let's say we have a vitamin C mask. It's like, this vitamin C mask is going to help with dark spots. It's an antioxidant. Everything pretty much a vitamin C serum promises, with a sheet mask, you're going to have to use one of them every single day for up to like a month, or however long it usually takes to see the difference from a serum, right? And no one's buying sheet masks in packs of 14, 28. Oh no, you can do actually, but who's doing that? But also for me, it's a time thing. One thing I like about my routines nowadays is that they're not quick, but they're one product, next product, next product, next product. Sometimes I will use a wash-off mask if I've really got the time and I really want to enjoy myself, but the majority of the time, I'm just going bam, bam, bam with my routine. It's not worth me spending money on all these products that I have to leave on the skin for longer than 5 minutes at a time, because I'm just not going to use them. And I always used to buy them thinking, oh, this is going to feel really nice and luxury, or when I have some me time, I'll do this. I'll use this when I have a bath. Like, I shower every day, but last time I had a bath, I don't even know. Eye patches are a little bit different, because the eye patches you usually get are like sheet masks, and you tend to have to use them in the serum stage. But again, I don't want to sit there with under eye patches on for ages, for like 10 minutes, to then wait to go into my moisturizer, if that makes sense. And same lip masks. Lip masks, they don't stick to your lips. Whatever, you have to kind of like sit like this for ages, and who has time to do that nowadays? Not me. I am using reusable under eye patches, because you could put them on your moisturizer stage, do your hair, and then take them off. You know, you're not waiting to move on to the next stage. But for me, it's just a waste of money, because I'm never going to use them. Or when I do, it doesn't warrant owning 5 clay masks or free packs of under eye patches. So I've had to stop myself from buying under eye patches that I know I love, clay masks that I know I used to love, and sheet masks that I used to use on a daily basis. That was an expensive habit. Cotton pads. Again, something we know are wasteful, but something I used to use all the time, literally on a daily basis to apply my toner. And it kind of just became a habit where I was like, oh, you know, you need cotton buds, you need cotton pads, along with your shampoo and deodorant, you know, like all the basics that you need. So yes, not only are they wasteful, but they also seep up a lot of product. And a lot of product goes to waste, especially if you're using toners. Not a lot of that gets onto your skin. But here's the thing as well. The toners that I prefer and that I like are thicker nowadays. They have this, I would say, full fat water feel to them. Most toners that I love, especially those Korean hydrating toners, are designed to go into your palm and then tap very gently onto the skin. And really, I know no other use for them other than that. But I swore by them when I had my really astringent toners back in the day. Micellar waters, you might want to use them for. And it is difficult because as much as people try and be environmentally conscious, a lot of reusable cotton pads are kind of shit. Like, they're not that great. So I just opt to not use them at all. Any kind of cotton pad. I do still get scent cotton pads by brands because they're still quite popular within K-beauty as well. There's a lot that are specially designed to fit certain areas of your face and to use as point masks. So you kind of douse it in a essence or a serum or a toner and leave it on an area that needs a lot of help. But nowadays you get so many cotton pads that are actually biodegradable, genuinely biodegradable, that are made of plant fibers. These biodegrade in anything from 10 months to a year, I think the average is, of these genuine biodegradable cotton pads. But for me, I was maybe spending like £2 for the good ones every single month for my whole life, and it kind of adds up. So now I just don't feel the need for them whatsoever. High percentage actives. Let's talk about that for a minute. Now, we've heard it all before, you know, higher isn't necessarily better, but here's the thing. I used to think there was like almost this graduation system to high percentage actives. Like, you know, I've used my 2% niacinamide, now I want to go into 5%, now I want to go into 10%. Oh my God, there's a 20%, there's a 100%. I used to think the goal was to carry on using it until your skin could cope with it, and then move on to the higher percentage, when that isn't the case at all. And even things like 2% BHAs, I've kind of cut down on because I've discovered my skin doesn't enjoy the higher percentages at all. And you know what? It does just fine with these lower percentage ingredients, these lower percentage actives. My skin loves a 5% niacinamide. Anything higher, it gets a little bit angry with me now. BHAs, even a 2%, like I said, it doesn't really like. Sometimes I go for betaine salicylate or a natural alternative willow bark extract. Especially when it comes to chemical exfoliants, you'll find that a lot of these higher percentages cost more money because they're like, we have a lot more of that really important active that you need for your skin, when this isn't the case. So you don't need to be buying these more expensive products. There are some high percentage actives that I absolutely love. The Kate Somerville exfoliate products are so good. So good. Does my skin need them? Once in a while, I will do one. But really what my skin loves is very low percentages and often over higher percentages and once a week. And I do feel like brands really jumped on the fact that people were really, really into actives last year. We thought they're the be-all and end-all of skincare. And they jumped onto that and, as I said, launched these higher percentage actives that no one needs. You don't need them. When all these actives have been shown to work at very good at a lower percentage, there's just no need. Oh, let's talk about Dermarollers. I used to love... Right, okay. Here's the thing. When I Dermarolled, it really, really, really helped my skin. It really did. Like, it helped with dark spots. It really helped remove those. Overall, kind of like brightness of my skin. The overall health of my skin, it really helped. However, it's something I regret recommending back then because I didn't know a lot back then. I didn't know the risks you take when you use these if you don't use these properly, and you really have to use these properly and safely when you use them. However, the thing with these is they're disposable. You have to get rid of them after a couple of tries, really a couple of goes. And these kits are expensive. They're very, very expensive for Dermarollers that have an actual pin head to them, not a flat kind of head to them. And I swore by these so much, I used to love them, that I would rebuy new ones all the time, and it got very, very expensive. And I just know nowadays, I wish I knew back then the kind of ingredients we have available now that do less purposeful damage to your skin, but give you equally good a result, if not a better result. This is probably something that all means if you know a dermatologist who you can go to and have this kind of thing done, definitely go and do it. If you're doing it and you have success with it, I've seen dermatologists be like, you can do this at home if you do it safely. I'm not going to recommend it because I'm not a dermatologist. I did it at home safely. I don't know. I was clean about it. Well, I thought I was disinfecting, I was putting rubbing alcohol on it. It's something that worked for my skin. Do I wish I didn't recommend it? Yes, 100%. I wish I never spoke about it. Dermarollers and Dermaroller kits are so expensive for something we don't really need and shouldn't really be using at home. Let's talk about single ingredient products, actually, because I've talked about this before and how I'm kind of moving on from single ingredient products. A lot of people are like, oh my God, you're being paid by the Inky List to talk shit about The Ordinary. That's not how stuff, honestly. I don't know where that's come from. That's not the case. The reason I personally don't use single ingredient products anymore, serums mainly, is because I bought so many of them. I bought so many of them thinking I needed everything, using them at all different times, trying to figure out when they needed to go into my routine, when can I use them all throughout the week, basically. And yeah, they're affordable. They're like £4, let's say, each. But the need, the way they pushed to buy everything, it adds up. It adds up so much when you can buy one single serum, for example, that has niacinamide, hyaluronic acid, azelaic acid, all in one go, for example. So that's three serums in one. But for example, like toners, I love toners. A lot of toners come with actives now, not just exfoliating toners, but toners with niacinamide in, toners with vitamin C in. But yeah, really understanding what my concerns were, kind of linking them to an ingredient that would help, then just finding those single products that would work rather than spreading out has really, really cut costs. I think this is still why I love essences. For me, sometimes I'll do a cleanser, an essence, a moisturizer, and sunscreen, because a lot of essences have those serum qualities to them, especially for ingredients that I like niacinamide, calming ingredients like centella. I kind of, you know, get it all in one. I think we all went a little serum crazy last year. No problem with it. I just think we need to calm down. That being said, I know we all love our skincare steps. You know, if you're watching this channel, it's probably because you're like me and you're obsessed with skincare and you buy it a lot and you use a lot and you have an extravagant routine. However, as much as essences and toners are different, because of the skincare world evolving and what brands are coming out with now, a lot of them are just merging into the same thing. They're merging into exactly the same products. You even see essence/toners, toners/essences nowadays. And again, that's another step where you can kind of cut costs now. If, like me, have your favorite essence and you have your favorite toner, stick with it. But if you really don't have the means for that, don't think that you have to have a separate essence and a toner. There are so many products that kind of merge two-in-ones now without being like a three-in-one body wash, where we just don't need as many steps in our routine and to spend as much money on each step of the routine as we used to do. But yes, let me know where you've cut costs in your routine in the comments down below. Also, once again, thank you to Karma for sponsoring today's video. Also, great at helping me save money and organizing my shopping habits. But yes, you can watch some light entertainment here and some product reviews right here, and I'll see you over there.